Hi guys, I'm GD Jones and welcome to the Real Life Tennis Practice Court. In this Coach's Corner segment, we're going to be working on the volley, in particular the technique of the volley. Now, as always with technique, we have the philosophy that if you're hitting the ball really well, if your shot's working for you, you don't want to mess around with something that's not broken. In the case of my student here today, his name is Matt, he's working on his forehand volley, and he's been struggling a little bit when the ball comes hard. If people are hitting really big, powerful, adult-like passing shots, he's finding that he's catching the ball just a little bit late, not controlling it that well. We can see from the slow-mo on side on of his forehand volley that he has quite a big backswing and quite an excessive follow-through. So today we're going to give him some tips on how he can fix that. And one of the philosophies that we have at Real Life Tennis is that you don't just want to tell a person what not to do, you want to tell them the right things to do. In the case of Matt and his forehand volley, we want to give him the tools to hit the ball powerfully and effectively rather than just tell him not to swing too much backswing or swing with too much follow through. Now there are two main tools that you want to use to get that power. The first is having a really strong grip squeeze. So if you set up for your forehand volley knee, as you're going to make contact, you want to feel like you're really squeezing your wrist hard. So if you just step forward and hit it and stop on contact, there, nice. Give me your racket. You want to feel like if you're squeezing my hand, that you're really going to break it. It's a really powerful, that should really hurt me. Now you're not quite strong enough, I think, to really make my hand sting, but you'll get there. And one way that you can build that strength, you just take a ball in your right hand, you're going to hold it out and squeeze it as high as you can for 3 seconds. 1, 2, 3, now relax and let it just go into your fingertips. Give your arm a 3 second break. 1, 2, 3, now back in. Really squeeze it hard. And you can do this with a soft ball, a sponge ball, a stress ball, or it's just a tennis ball, and it's a really good way of building up your grip strength. And that grip strength is what you want as you're making contact. Rather than generating power with a big backswing and a big follow-through, it's really squeezing your racket on impact. Now the second thing for getting quality power effectively on your volley is having a big step into the ball. Now if you set up, I want you to pretend that you're going to make contact with the ball right here. So to do it, you're going to have a big step forward. Ready? Just hit my strings. Good. We can see here how far Matt stepped into the ball. And that step, that momentum, is what's going to give you effective power, again, rather than having a big backswing and a big follow-through. So let's do some volleys now where you focus on those two things. Try and limit your backswing and your follow-through and generate the power with the grip squeeze and the step. Good one. Big step. Good. Good squeeze. Excellent. That's a really solid contact. Nice. Good finish. Good job. Hopefully those two tips on the volley will really help you, the grip squeeze and getting a big step into the shot. For more tips on how to improve your game, head over to reallifetennis.com. We'll see you next time.